Just in, Hawaii Attorney General pushes to block Trump again after Supreme Court victory. At the beginning of the week, the Supreme Court ruled that the travel restrictions, which President Trump was attempting to put into place, could go into effect. As you can imagine, liberals' heads were exploding. One particular liberal loon who seems to have lost his mind is the Hawaii Attorney General Douglas Chen. Mr. Chen seems to not understand that no matter what he does, the Supreme Court has the final say. Mr. Chen, who does not believe in protecting Americans, and is only interested in making a name for himself within the Democratic Party, not necessarily a highlight, filed an emergency challenge to stop the decision of the Supreme Court, even though the travel restrictions the Supreme Court ruled on went into effect as of Thursday, June 29, 2017. The travel ban, or restrictions, whichever way you choose to call it, allows the United States government to put in place a 90-day ban on travel for those individuals coming from Iran, Libya, Syria, Somalia, Sudan, and Yemen. Specifically, if the traveler does not have close family ties or established business relationships in the United States, they are subject to being denied entry into the United States. Makes sense, right? To not allow people into our homeland that may want to kill us? Well, not for the loony left and folks like Mr. Chen. They are under some sort of delusion that we should just let everyone in and be nice. Right. And we saw how well lazy travel restrictions have worked in the United Kingdom. And just so we are clear, this travel ban does not affect those travelers who already have a valid green card or visa. This travel ban affects people from Iran, Libya, Syria, Somalia, Sudan, and Yemen, with no legitimate and established connection in the United States, who may want to kill Americans. However, as reported by Alex Johnson from NBC News, Mr. Chen stated in Hawaii, close family includes many of the people that the federal government decided on its own to exclude from that definition, AG Chen said in a statement. Unfortunately, this severely limited definition may be in violation of the Supreme Court ruling. Those who not fall under the definition of close family established by the State Department include grandparents, grandchildren, aunts, uncles, nieces, nephews, cousins, brothers and sisters-in-law, and any other extended family members. So basically what Mr. Chen is saying is, since Hawaii's definition of close family is different than that of the State Department and the Trump administration, we should be nice and let all these other refugees in without taking time to properly vet them, and make sure they are not terrorists or have ties to terrorists. And remember, the Supreme Court has ruled the travel restrictions are constitutional and enforceable, along with the definitions the State Department and the Trump administration has outlined. But yet the loony left and Mr. Chen seem not to care about the Supreme Court or the law. Not surprising, since most Democrats treat the law's suggestions, that is Hillary Clinton for example. What is truly shocking about the actions taken by Mr. Chen is, he expects a lone U.S. district judge to overrule the Supreme Court of the United States. Where did this guy go to law school? I am not a lawyer, but even I know a U.S. district judge can't overrule the Supreme Court. The U.S. district judge, which Mr. Chen petitioned, Judge Derek Watson, ruled back in March that close family does include grandparents, grandchildren, aunts, uncles, nieces, nephews, cousins, brothers and sisters-in-law, and any other extended family members. But that pesky Supreme Court got in the way of this ruling, thought otherwise, and now Mr. Chen is confused, and expects a U.S. district judge to defy the Supreme Court. The actions taken by Mr. Chen, along with CARE, and all these other bleeding-heart lunatic liberals, camping out at airports, is exactly why Donald Trump was elected. A majority of Americans are tired of the crap coming from the left, not putting America first, and thinking that it is racist to protect our citizens. I'm truly convinced folks like Mr. Chen are obtuse to what is going on in the world, and are only interested in their ideals, no matter if they get people killed. Here is a perfect example. Camille Mackler, Director of Legal Initiatives for the New York Immigration Coalition and member of the American Immigration Lawyers Association, actually said, "What I'm worried could happen is what the Department of State intends to happen, is a grandfather and grandmother gets denied a visa, people who we believe would still fit with what the Supreme Court intended. What? Did this woman who is supposed to be a lawyer not read the Supreme Court decision? Grandparents are not considered close family, and the Supreme Court ruled this is constitutional. What does the left not understand about this whole issue? If a person is not a United States citizen, and they have no close family or business ties in the United States, then the Department of State can deny them a visa, as they have no right or constitutional basis to demand entry into a country which they are not a citizen of. Those fighting the Supreme Court decision are living in a fantasy land, and the Supreme Court is not drinking the left's Kool-Aid. At least not for the time being on this issue. Thank God we have a president in office now that is actually concerned with protecting Americans, and could care less about offending snowflakes like Mr. Chen or Camille Mackler. Here is a tip to the left: America is tired of your crap. We are putting America and Americans first. Deal with it.